Hi everyone, welcome to another session of number restoration of serial numbers. So in this session we are going to discuss about electrolytic methods of restoration. So electropolishing, it's a term, it's a process actually. So electropolishing is a process where the specimen is made the anode and like in an electrochemical cell, and the electrolyte solution is the cathode. So when a current is applied, like minute irregularities in the surface are dissolved and leaving a highly polished surface. So electropolishing means is actually a process of polishing a surface in which the specimen means the sample is made as anode, and the electrolytic solution is considered as cathode, and this specimen is placed in an electrochemical cell and a current is applied. So when the current is applied, what will happen? Minute irregularities in the surface are dissolved. This minute irregularities are dissolved, and this leaves a polished surface. Then after that we will get a polished surface. So this is the process of electropolishing. This is a process of polishing a surface. So here the specimen, that is our sample, is made as anode, and the electrolytic solution in the electrochemical cell is act as cathode, and this is placed in an electrochemical cell, and a current is applied here, and after that when we apply the current, minute irregularities on the surface of that particular specimen is dissolved, and we will get an polished surface. So this will get a polished surface, and as the electrical properties of the stamped area are minutely altered due to the compressed crystalline structure, the dissolution of the compressed area will be different from that of non-compressed area. So this is the like principle of this electrolytic method of restoration. So this thing was first discovered or developed about 25 years ago, and this was by Arai and Chiago. In their paper it was the mentioned 1953, and this has proved to be a successful method of number restoration. So electrolytic method, like chemical etching method, is one of the successful method which we can restore the serial numbers. And in this method, the anode is specimen, and the quaternions have containing the electrolytical solution becomes the cathode, as I said, and an external variable DC voltage is applied and adjusted to the just greater than minimum voltage necessary for the current flow, and this is called as critical voltage. So critical voltage for different I will write here critical voltage. What is critical voltage? This is different for different metals, and critical voltage means when we are applying an external current, we are applying an external current or DC voltage. So this is adjusted to be greater than minimum voltage. This external current we are applying is greater than minimum voltage. Necessary for the current flow, to flow. So this is called as critical voltage. We have to apply a current. I told you like specimen is act as anode and the solution is act as cathode, and this is placed in a chemical cell, electrochemical cell, and current is applied. So the current applied is the DC voltage, and this should be greater than minimum voltage necessary for the current to flow. So that voltage is called as critical voltage. So this is critical voltage is different for all the metals. So I will write here the critical voltage of different metals. So it's steel, it's 6 voltage. The critical voltage is 6 volt, and brass it is 7 volt, and for aluminium it is 7.5 volt. So this critical voltage is different for different metals. For steel it is approximately 6 volt, and for brass it is approximately 7 volt, and for aluminium it is 7.5 volt. And next is the reagents used for this one. Reagents. So the electrolytic solution is we are giving to this electrochemical cell. For steel, what reagent we will give? For steel we are using two types of chemical solutions. So first solution is two types we are giving. First solution is cupric sulfate 1 gram, then 15 ml sulfuric acid H2SO4, then 1 gram of gelatin, and 500 ml of water. So this is one reagent we used for the one solution we use for the electrochemical cell. First is for steel, cupric sulfate 1 gram, 15 ml of H2SO4, 1 gram gelatin, and 500 ml of water. This solution is one solution we are giving to the electrochemical cell. And second one is 5 gram cupric ammonium chloride, 1 gram cupric ammonium chloride, 5 gram, sorry, then 50 ml of HCl plus 50 ml of water. So 5 gram of cupric ammonium chloride, then 50 ml of HCl, and 50 ml of H2O. So these are the two reagents we are using for steel. And next is for aluminium. So aluminium we are using the solution 17% H2SO4 sulfuric acid and 2% of fluoroboric acid. So this is the solution used for aluminium. 17% of H2SO4 and 2% of fluoroboric acid. So this is about electrolytic methods of restoration. So electrolytic method, electropolishing is a method or a process used here. So electropolishing is a process where the specimen is made the anode in an electrochemical cell, and when a current is applied, minute irregularities in the surface are dissolved, and this leaves a highly polished surface. And as the chemical properties of the stamped area are minutely altered due to the compressed crystalline structure, the dissolution of the compressed area will be different from that of the non-compressed area. If this was first developed by Arai and Shiago, and it was about 25 years ago, and has proved to be a successful method of serial number restoration. And for different metals, they are using different solutions. So steel, they are using these two solutions, and for aluminium, they are using H2SO4 and fluoroboric acid. And one more term I'm introducing here for you is critical voltage. So critical voltage, here we are applying an external current, that is the DC voltage. So this should be greater than the minimum voltage necessary for the current to flow. So that voltage is called as critical voltage. So it will be different for different metals, and for steel it is approximately 6 voltage, and for brass it is 7 voltage, and for aluminium it is 7.5 voltage. So I hope you understood about the electrolytic methods of restoration. If you have any doubts in this, you are free to ask. So I am winding up here. Thank you.